Hi, I'm Sally here. I'm owner of SHH Textile. I'm currently is 38 years old. I'm a director of SHH already in 10 years ago until now. Today, I want to share about up and down while I'm doing this business. I hope you guys can enjoy it. Actually, this company is from my father, because my family, grandfather is doing textile, so I'm third generation at this moment in the textile industry. So I continue my father's business. I think when 1997, my father thinks that he's ready to move into a bigger company. So that time my father bought a property in Dharma Shamaling Perkasa, currently this location. And very bad is like we have a issue like economy boom at that 1997. So he has like facing some problems to the financials. I think very fast like 1998 good dia sudah recover, kita sudah buka like have a boutique for the perempuan, and then we have like our own brand for the lucky, and then we have like another departments like jahitan juga, yeah. Since after I graduate my university, then I joined these companies. I think about 2016. Actually, after I enter this company, I have facing a lot of problem. Like first thing, like boycott. I think this is the most important point for me. I facing a lot of this problem. Because I'm owner of the SHH, the daughter. Yeah, I think everyone maybe have this issue in the future. If your business is successful, then your children coming out, you will face this the same problems too. Okay, since that time, I do my own searching my new customer. I find my own new supplier. So A to Z, I'm learning from my own self. Okay, so before SHH, the textile, the customer mostly 100% is Chinese. So, but then because I get a boycott the period, so I changed the customer slowly to 100% to 99% to a Muslim customer, Malay customer like that. Yeah. So maybe about like 3 months, below 3 months. Yeah. I think after the one of the shareholder already go out from SHH. That time actually is our top earning money. That time kita 100% is cash, and then we get a lot of like the sales target is double up. Everything is by cash, yeah, like that. About 12 million. Because my father, when the shareholder go out that time, my father have a sick in a year. So that time, I know that he have a cancer, stage 3. So it's quite upset because of like a year before the shareholder go out, we have like double sales and we have get the 12 million by cash. But after 1 year, my father got the cancer. I'm very upset about that. Yeah, because it's stage 3, the doctor said that he'll be going die in within 3 years. So I love my father more than I love the company. So that time I give up my business, even though it's a very good sales, but I didn't maintain it because I believe that father is more important than the business, because business is can ongoing. I'm not like close shop. I just let it on hold and let him run his own self. And then I take care of my father in that 3 years, because I believe that father is very important than the business. Business can be continued once you are ready, you're coming out, you can get it continue back your business. Yeah. Happens that I have actually the one shareholder is pegang this company very, very well. So my father really did like backwards, like financials persons. So my father is very long time never touch about the business, but he's just at the back the financial shareholder already went out. At that time, we got the 12 million. But that time, we were worried about, actually, we worried about that. Is it we can do this business or not without this shareholder? I didn't tell my father, and father also didn't tell, he worried. Then we both each other very hardworking about doing the business. And then we did the first year very good sales, but second year my father got sick. Then I have a problem again because I worry about my father. And people say that we will close the shop. Close the shop means like bankrupt ke, tak boleh continue ini company lagi ke, kerana itu like shareholder sudah keluar yang kita punya company. So they say that this company is run from the shareholder, it's not my father. So that's why I also truly say that I'm very very takut juga, very nervous juga. Can I do that? Can I handle this company without the shareholder? Because I also very young, only 23 years old. I didn't know that I can do that or not. But I need to stand up that I say to the public, I can do it. Because I cannot show people I'm the very weakness person. I cannot handle about this business. Even though I'm nervous, even though I don't know how to run this business, I still need to like tell my own self that I can do it. I need to stand up to show people that how good image am I. So that time I really did it. I'm very successful until now. But in the middle, I worry about like the guy go out. Can I continue? And my father also passed away. And can I do it without my father? I still can continue this business or not? So this is my own Sally being a worry lah. But I don't show out from other people. But at the end today, you interview because I'm really stable. So I just tell out my previous history. Sharing to each other like that. I couldn't say that I'm successful because I never pass until my age like 50 or 60 years old. So I don't think that I can say it that I'm successful. But in this situation, I quite stable. Like I facing a lot of problem, I still can fix it and still can stable in the market. So I think I can do it until I 50 years old, 60 years old, bring my company to my next generations. Yeah. My future plan, actually I wish that have a franchise coming out. Why? Because this business actually can make money. So a lot of people do know that the textile, I want to share it on textile to my customer or my coming the audience, because textile is really very important for Malaysia market. A lot of people is like Muslim in Malaysia, they're wearing a tudung, they're wearing a baju, jubah, that kind of thing. So textile is quite part of very important part to for supply to the people like doing this kind of like hijab, baju ke macam ini. But I wish that someone to do the franchise with us, because this business really bring, first thing, will bring you to earn money. Secondly, actually this business really can bring you goal. Like secondly, why I'm saying that it can make money, because in the market really don't have a retail textile in the market, like very exclusive fabric, limited additional and higher quality punya textile retail tak ada di Malaysia. So this is very can be saying a unique shop, and then you can do your business in the future. I wish to share my things, my textile with my other people also, because this thing really can help people. And market really don't have the competitor like a very exclusive fabric selling in the market. So why not you open a franchise? Because Sally only only a child. I can't like open like in the Malaysia whole everywhere. I can have one location, but I wish to share my SHH with other people. That's why I look to my dear self. I know that you really have a problem a lot facing when you're small. Until now, you still can fix it. And I wish you can like bring your positive to future and don't give up and still fight until the end.
Make young student struggle.
Now we really have a problem because of like COVID-19 kan, everyone have a business problem struggling kan. I pun ada actually. Everyone have. If I tell you don't have, I think mission impossible lah. Okay, everyone have this problem also, but we need to stay very, very stable thinking, and then don't give up. Have this any problem issue coming out, don't give up. This is my words lah. I always like don't give up. Facing problem, we need to fix it, and how we go through by this problem. Once you go through this very tough period, you will be a very successful person. Believe me, this is the truth. So, like getting like more vitamin for our own self and for our body, then we will get more better in the future our business. So thank you very much to watching my video. Hope my video can share to you more idea and for the business idea. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and press your notification bell and share it and send our comment below. Follow our Instagram, Facebook like, and our TikTok. See you guys.